Hey, what's up, JK Party people? We are back, and today we are playing another round of Drunk, Stoned, or Stupid. And we have my special guest, our very own Uncle Harold.
Hey. Hi, everybody.
Oh, yeah, Gina's here too. Let's play.
All right, guys. Bart, you are the judge. So the first person to 5 cards loses.
Okay.
Take it away.
Okay.
Not gonna be me.
Good luck, Uncle Harold.
Hey.
There you go.
Has a really fucked up sense of humor.
Oh, I think that's all of us.
Yeah.
That's all of us.
I mean, I'm innocent like crazy.
I'm gonna say Joe.
Why are you always
you gotta
me?
Give a.
Why is Harold?
Because.
Joe's not
I'm
here.
Harold! Yeah!
But wait, we know nothing about Harold!
Well, you know what's the funny thing? Joe and Harold are very similar people.
Yeah.
So okay. if you know Gerald, I mean Gerald.
Gerald!
Gerald! Joe, you know Harold.
Ship.
Okay, guys, the secret's out. I'm Joe. Undercover work,
yeah. You know. You're good. Yeah.
You're really good. I didn't even know.
So why did a spy espionage?
One time he tried to drown the baby. Yeah.
You did want a baby?
He tried to drown the baby.
So Josh says that one time I tried to drown a baby. If for him drowning means give a baby a bath, then I'm guilty as charged because I was helping out my cousin and I was sponging the shit out of the baby because she was busy cooking dinner. So if I'm guilt, you're gonna call me guilty for being a good person? Fine. But that's not really a fucked up sense of humor. Mm. I think what that means is I'm just a helpful ass motherfucker.
And we don't have that card.
Mm-hmm.
No.
But you know who has a really fucked up sense of humor is?
Who?
It's too easy. Julia! Is because you find humor in popping pimples.
Ew, that's so true.
That's not fucked up. That's just gross.
That's not humor.
That's pretty fucked up.
It's humor. Pretty close.
That's just gross, though.
It's gross and
fucked up.
It's just gross. You know the person that I think that has a fucked up sense of humor is Gio because she thinks of really fucked up punishments on these JK party games.
Alright, well if we're thinking of fucked up punishments then, we know who the leader of Dromalia's punishment department's gonna be because he thinks of some fucked up ass shit to torture the fucked up people and laughs about it. That's Bart.
I'm the judge, so.
Oh, come on! Come on!
I thought you were gonna say me because I'm Dromalian.
Yeah. Oh, well then, who has that department of fucked up torture? And hires people.
He employs the people.
Yes, it's the leader himself, Dromalia.
But it's not a sense of humor because I'm not laughing.
I'm killing.
And I'm angry and I'm mad and I want justice. Who has the darkest humor here? Gina likes some of the craziest, darkest humors.
Wait, what?
The things that you see on YouTube, the things that I go on your Facebook and the things that you post, it is crazy.
Like what?
I
have
to give a reason.
Yeah, you gotta give a reason.
If Josh could do it, I could do it too.
No, it has to go back to you because Jamalia was made.
I know you do.
Humor.
I don't know. No. I know you.
It's yours. You gotta call it.
Honestly, I would have to go with Julia on this one. And the reason why is because the evidence shows that the closest thing is Pimple Bob. Is pimple popping, eyeball gouging, when there's someone hit by a car and the arms are splattered on the side of the road.
But I don't find that
like,
funny.
Oh my god.
Julia, girl.
Sometimes you'll be reporting some fucked up news and you have a smile on your face.
Yeah, you're great.
Like, why?
Oh, it's okay, it's to 5. You only have one.
Yeah.
It's alright.
I'll take it.
We'll become a millionaire and blow it all.
Oh,
yeah,
that one.
I wonder.
Uh-oh. Who's the closest to being that right now? And who spends the most money?
On crazy shit.
Useless things.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Yes.
They want a whole wall full of it.
Mm-hmm. How much did that weight cost?
What about those glasses?
Yeah.
And that shirt?
Yeah, but I mean, what about that watch?
What about it?
I don't know.
Man, this game is going quick.
I only spend 10% of my wealth. And y'all know that although the things that I buy is quite reckless, you better hope to God I don't lose it all because I'm also in charge of all the finances of the company. But I do know this other person that likes to spend. She always buys things when she travels all over the world.
No, but here's the thing. I buy little things that may add up to like a good amount, but I don't splurge and go crazy. The Jaguar Range Rover and a Rolls Royce.
It's not splurge. But it's not splurging.
Are you hoarding the money?
It's responsible. If you look at my bank account, you would know that I'm only spending a quarter of what I have total in fun stuff.
Damn, you're rich.
I'm pretty fucking rich. I think we should talk about who ends up blowing everything in their bank account. Who is guilty of that?
I think it has to be one of the Mexicans.
Yep.
Mexicans are known to spend.
Fuck you, I have zero debt.
And their finances are the worst.
Good for you, me too.
Yeah, I don't have debt.
As of recent.
But you know what? I helped you clear your debt.
Oh my god.
I didn't pay for it. I didn't pay for it, but I created a financial strategy
Shit's
to get her out
real.
Of motherfucking debt. Mm. You're welcome very much. Bam.
Bitch, damn.
But do you even know how I got into that debt? No,
yourself.
No.
Only you are to blame.
Because I'm a young mother and I had to put a lot of shit on credit so I can support the family that I have.
You go, girl.
So that's not being irresponsible. It's being the most responsible. So, and not only that, but I actually paid it all off. So, anyways, I'm going back to Joe because you, honestly, dude, if you were a millionaire, you would spend it all on trying to create your Jomalian country and you would go broke for that.
I have always said I wish you were a millionaire so I could see all the weird shit you're gonna buy.
You guys really want me to go broke?
But it actually does spend only a quarter though.
It says, will become a millionaire. That might be true. No, that will be true. And blow it all. See, the key word is blow it all.
I don't think you need
it's on you,
back.
Josh.
Cambodia.
It's on you, Josh.
Cambodia.
That's it. We got
I don't blow it all. And you guys better hope to God I don't blow it all because if I do, everybody here is screwed.
I'm gonna say Jack.
Well, kind of.
The judge has spoken.
So you want your boss? You want your boss to blow all the money? How are we all gonna get paid? What the hell?
He really doesn't have to give a reason, actually.
Yeah, he's the judge.
We already gave all the reasons.
True.
I just want to know.
I think that you're the closest person.
Which law school did you go to?
Because then, knowing you, you don't really like blow through.
You're the one who matches the card the most. At
yeah, you don't really, like, I've known you for a while. You don't
That's
really blow through
reason.
Your money.
At That's
all.
A great
you,
like, reason.
If anything, you just like, you have your money set in like different like portions, but then you never actually go through it in like one go. You're just like, okay, I'm gonna spend this much, and then you just complain about it later on, and that's it.
Good job. You see, that
he
was
does,
great.
He does observing me well.
That was great.
I guess I do apply to the first part, so yeah. I could have incriminated Bart,
but then you're a gambler, cool. So then you'd probably blow it off.
That's what I was saying. I'm like, Cambodia?
I won last time.
Finds everything on Craigslist. I feel like this car would go to Gio because she likes to find the best deals on like there's like eBay, Etsy. I'm pretty sure you go on Craigslist. Mm.
Wait, what? I'm the least one to find that because I have no time, so I don't bargain shop ever.
Mm. But you found and linked Tiff a few desks for the office.
Yeah, that's an artisanal website though, so it's not anything close to it. But the person who did get their shit on Craigslist is actually Tiffany.
Oh, shit.
This, if you guys know. Read this, it says everything.
But
on
you're
Craigslist.
The closest.
You're the closest.
I have only button.
Button.
Two items.
That's a lot.
Button.
Yes.
Yeah, you button that shit.
I didn't hear myself say that. I've only bought two things, so I don't think this applies to me. If anything, I feel like it would apply to, I'm trying to think.
I know you are.
I can't pin it on anyone else. Mm-mm. I don't know what you buy in your life.
I'm bougie as fuck. I don't like you stuff.
I feel like your Cantonese side would want to come out and bargain shop.
Not crazy though. I feel like. Fuck it, I have no idea. It's mine. Will coach a kids soccer team and be way too into it. Well, based off of JK Party.
In all the holes.
How hard we game, I would say this would be Joe's
card. What?
Oh. Uncle Harold.
Uncle Harold.
I'm thinking like way into it, like he'll dress up like the mascot or the mascot and bring sandwiches for everyone and shit. Are we talking like that into it? Or
I mean,
no, like take it seriously.
Oh, I see.
See,
I
feel like he'd be running on the side.
I will be into it, but I won't be coaching it. I think this is Bart because he seems like someone who would actually coach the sport, get involved. Be involved in coaching the kid and then beating the fuck out of the other team and the kid if they lose. Yeah. That's Bart. Because me, I'll just go in there and beat the hell out of the kids, but I wouldn't coach the kids. I'm too lazy for that.
I will admit to the facts that I did grow up in a very Asian tiger home. And yes, I hold kids up to a very high standard. If they fuck up, I have no problem fucking them up and beating the fuck out of them. And yes, my team will go to the Olympics. And if they don't,
self-incriminating.
And if they don't, I'm gonna put all of them in a wheelchair. They don't deserve to play soccer.
Damn. There we go. So you keep your card.
No, but.
Ooh, there's a but.
But there is someone here that actually has access to a kid, and I see him coach him on many things.
Will coach a kid's soccer team.
And he's a good coach too.
One, I don't coach, I teach.
Same thing.
Guidance.
It all goes to Latin. It starts with Latin, like doctor or something, which means to teach.
Well, I don't see this being too probable, just only because Isaac isn't that into sports to begin with.
Soccer. Likes to swim.
Yeah, but this is soccer though. Kids soccer team, not swim team. And be way into it. I'm actually pretty hands off when it comes to extra. I'm just like, teacher, take it away. I'm here to just kind of convey and make sure he's behaving. And then I'm gonna be on Instagram. All right.
Great dad.
But what if you were put in the position to be the swim teacher?
Mm-mm. And it's soccer. I don't know how to play soccer either. Mm-hmm. I think it still has to go back to Joe. Yeah. I feel like Joe is just a very involved human being. You're involved with like all of our. I mean, yeah, you are our boss and stuff, but like you're a very caring person underneath the cynicism that you portray. And because of that, I think you would get really into the game. Mm-hmm. I think you would also bring out the best in children because you love children. I see the way you interact with them. You're always teaching them instruments and stuff. I don't even do that.
Dinosaurs.
You're buying him gifts all the time. I don't even do that.
You're a great person. Wow.
You're such an awesome person.
I'm just there to make sure you behave. So I think you make a better coach than I would.
But, although I'm fucking awesome.
This is the last one.
There's one person that we haven't really pointed out. Mm. And this person is an awesome, awesome teacher, motivator, persuader of children, and also gets really involved and will beat other kids. And this is this creature. And it's soccer, she's Mexican. Oh! Oh.
Mexican. You're a great mom.
Come on,
you're great with kids.
She's great.
You're great.
You see the way she leads her dog?
What?
Her dog almost ate a puppy yesterday. She was like, no, it's not. No, it's not that dog's fault. Damn, you could already see the soccer mom developing.
Okay, I think that card has to go with Bart.
And yeah!
There have
been
many times
when
you're like, want to beat the shit out of my kid because I'm like, you're self-incriminating.
Many times.
That's you, girl.
Just keep the card.
No, I can win this one.
Have sketchy friends.
Oh.
Oh, he knows.
He knows.
He. We have the same mutual friends, but you.
So does that make you guilty too?
But you go way back with them, and you've done way more with them than I ever had. Most I've ever done was go clubbing with them, and that's it. You.
Yeah.
You know who I'm talking about.
I changed my life, and you still hang out.
I know. I haven't seen them, and you've seen them last.
I have friends on both sides of the law.
I do too. My uncle's a sheriff in
my friend I went to high school with is a sheriff in LA. They might be friends together.
So who's the real? Bart! I don't ever hang out with these people anymore. What are you talking about?
Wait, what's your reason? You just said Bart.
I just did a joke.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone knows on Just Kidding News that you speak about them shady days when you used to do the dirty dirty.
But this.
You guys should just rip the card in half.
No. This is over 10 years ago. I don't talk to them anymore. I don't text them. I don't even have their numbers. I don't even know where they are. I have no idea where the hell they are. But I have seen some of Gina's friends. And for some reason, I remember seeing a picture of a guy with a black bar over his eyeballs. No reason why.
Friends with black bars on the eyeball.
And that's common,
That is
I have a lot of friends with black bars on their MySpaces, Instagrams, Facebooks, and I know
what
they
do. You have the same friend!
That's our mutual friend!
I don't do that stuff anymore, I don't know who they are anymore.
In fact...
So does it count if we all three have the same friends?
The last time, the person who's seen them most recently is you when you ran into them and said, oh hey, what up dude? You told me about it! I haven't seen them in years!
But you know what, Gina? I'm the judge. And Bart did bring up a good point, and that was the most recent. The friend with black bars and eyes.
No!
That card belongs to you!
Fine. Fine.
I accidentally ran into them, so we didn't plan the date.
You can get it back. You'll be the judge next.
Fine!
I don't even know if this applies, but fuck it. It's a troll.
Okay. Troll.
Well then, there you go, Josh. You're definitely a troll.
You laugh.
You like to act one way off camera.
Yup.
And as soon as the camera's on, you're like, Gio, why are you bullying me?
Yeah.
That's you, Josh.
Wow.
You took a seat.
People actually believe that act. That's why they go, why are you guys picking on Josh? Josh is so innocent.
Yeah, Josh. But
oh my god. We cut
him in our heart.
Okay. One, I am not a troll. And the reason why is a troll is someone that likes to just like play a lot of like practical jokes. And I feel as though this card is more for Joe.
Because
every single one, it's been me.
Yeah, Josh always
does.
He likes picking on me.
No, what do you have against Joe, you troll? I'm not a troll. All right, so what is the definition of a troll in your opinion?
You.
J-O-S-H. Dub hollow.
Hello,
hello. A troll is someone that likes to just like play practical jokes, and I don't like playing practical jokes.
But I gave a good example. I just said off camera you're talking all the smack, and then on camera, Gio.
If you were butt naked and you had a ruby in your belly button, you would look like a treasure troll.
Such an old reference.
That's adorable. A little belly button. I want a jewel in my belly button.
If anything, I'd say this card belongs to Julia. And the reason why,
the reason why
is because sometimes I'll go up to you and I'll say hi and you'll just be like, give me the longest stare as if I did something bad and I'll just like look
yeah,
around.
Yeah, because you scarred me for life.
How have I scarred you for life?
You scarred me for life.
How?
You're so mean to me.
I'm not mean to you.
You're like, Julia, I love you, man.
No, I say hi and you're just like.
That's why I give you that look where like. I'm just a little bit caught in the middle. Life is a maze and love is a riddle. I don't know where to go. Like, who am I talking to? Am I talking to on camera Josh or off camera?
No! No! No!
No!
No!
Everyone does.
No, alright, earlier before we were rolling, I was like, hey Julia, what's up? And then she was like, oh, and I was like, holy shit. And then
that's because you threw a punch at me!
I didn't throw a punch at you!
You threw a punch at me!
You punched me!
It was out of reflex and defense!
No, it was not!
Yeah.
Such bullshit! No, the card belongs to you!
It's like a big
banger.
Right
no!
That's
enough
out of you. Okay, this card goes. Oh man, it's kind of hard because I want to say you too.
Whoa.
But you're the judge. Why would you say him?
No one. No.
It's too late. You too.
No one even nominated me.
Because I feel bad for all the times that you farted in front of Gio and ruined his life.
I haven't done that in
and
like 5 years.
And earlier when I dropped the cap to my water, I was gonna reach and grab it, and you pretended you were gonna pick it up. And you move it further. I was like, what the fuck?
I did see that happen.
I'm a soccer coach.
You saw that!
I'm a soccer
even if you're proven to be a mafia, you're like, no, I'm a detective, and you instigate everyone against each other too. Bart, this is.
You just gotta give it to him.
Bart, this is yours, man.
No, I'm not gonna give it to
him.
I like how she talked herself into it too,
because
like she was still
waiting
to
confused.
And
then
she went, that's so
funny. I've never seen.
I've never seen
that, Josh.
You need to put a jewel in your belly button.
You're not here long, like,
enough. I know, so I can't really, and then Julia's just not a troll at all. Bart,
I know.
Yeah.
You know.
Me
and Casey and Jill, we tried to prank my mom that I broke my neck with a wheelchair.
And she cried.
That's what I said.
She cried.
See, you're the troll.
I am a troll.
I'm right.
Gets trapped by a revolving door.
That's a funny one.
I feel like you would do that to yourself.
Yeah. Joe?
Yeah, I don't know why.
I'm goofy, yeah. But I'm not stupid.
Stupid? Oh my god, I've heard that so
I'm
long.
I'm not stupid.
Not stupid.
But I don't know, who gets into physical troubles?
Who's clumsy?
Julia's pretty clumsy.
Julia
fell off a stool and she ran into a door.
And the camera hit too, she like kicked one of them.
You are pretty clumsy.
I can't fight against it. I really can't. Like, as much as I would love to defend myself, no.
Never wants to do anything.
Who's that one?
I can only imagine. Mm. Especially because Bart's the picker.
I would have to say Casey.
Oh!
I always hear Tiff complaining about how she wants to do this, but Casey never wants to do it with her.
Yep.
The reason why I don't want to do it with her is because I know I have prior commitments with editing and getting work done. Ooh, so I'm not exactly doing nothing. But in fact, though, when I do get hungry, I do want to go out and eat. Someone always denies me that.
Oh, yes, here we go.
Oh, okay, well, this one has something to do with anything. Who wakes up at 8 a.m. every morning to get some work done? Who wakes up at like 1 p.m.?
Liar! I don't wake up at 1 p.m. That's
12.
No.
After me.
I wake up after you.
And what do I do? I wake up and I try to wake you up and try to get us to both have a productive day. Who has more of a productive day?
All of us. Because we both get a lot of shit done. It's just that you get up earlier than me, yes.
I think Casey's
but productive. It doesn't mean that you get more work done than me.
It's a lot of waste of time there in the morning, I have to say.
Okay, like an hour in the morning and you wake up earlier than me? No.
You only have 24
no.
Those days.
Oh no. Casey. But you know what? This girl keeps staring at me because I think she knows that this card belongs to her.
I'll start back and forth. I get a lot of shit done. I came here today. I'm shooting a full day. I just got back from another country. I'm still jet lagged and I'm still here for you guys.
Excuse me. Good.
Yeah, I'm in another country. I went out of my way to go get souvenirs for you.
Ooh.
You.
Which I love you for.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. That you ate earlier.
Yes. And shared. Thank you.
So I do things. In fact, I do more things with you guys than I do with my own stuff. So this. Who doesn't want to do anything?
I feel like we're all pretty much down for anything.
Well, you're the judge.
I don't know.
Oh God! Get it out of there! Get it out!
I don't know what's more nasty, Joe's boogers on my drumstick or the fact that my drumstick's over 15 years old.
Really? You haven't been that long? Holy shit, that's crazy.
You never take care of anything. I'm so proud of you, baby.
Why are there bite marks on it?
It's the one that lasted. I bought this in like a big ass bundle and these are the last two that lasted all
over. Wow.
Wait, never wants to do anything. See, that's subjective. And that's
why you're the judge.
I guess the judge is saying doesn't want to do anything.
That means when you go, hey, you want to do this?
Nah.
That sounds like Casey to me.
What?
But see, I think you know what it is.
That sounds like you.
Because I'm down for anything.
Really?
Who loves Hawaii here? What? Between us.
You.
Exactly.
Who forces
me to go?
And I go.
I know I have to force you because you don't want to do anything.
It's not that I don't want to, I just don't like Hawaii.
Never want to do anything.
And Brandon, I'm not alone.
You don't like Hawaii?
What?
Someone turned the camera off.
Okay, you got help. All
right, well, you know what? I think that both of you are wrong because you both actually do like to do things. You just don't like to do what the other person likes to do.
Amen.
You like to go out and if at any moment I go, hey, let's go to this fucking new barbecue joint.
There.
Let's do it.
There.
If I tell you, let's go to...
Jump out of building. I'm there.
Do it. Although, I know Gina, even if she travels, she'd rather stay home all day. So this is yours.
Oh,
oh,
oh
no,
shit.
Not even.
Ow. No, that's oh, it.
He's the judge, so...
I'm the judge.
I mean, he's the judge.
It's true. I'm so fucking lazy.
I'm gonna hold on this
I am so fucking lazy.
You're good argumentative.
Shit. Yeah.
You're a good argumentative.
Yeah, you almost stood away from it, because I was like, that's true. Oh, wait, but that's true. Oh, wait, but yeah, that's true. Oh, you both are guilty.
Yeah.
It's high maintenance. High maintenance, yeah.
Maintenance.
I wonder who that is.
Do you have enough room for the another party?
Oh, I have enough room to argue. Trust me, I have enough fucking room to argue. Watch.
Okay.
Watch.
Well, he didn't even pick you. I'm just saying.
I know,
saying.
But I'm just saying, just watch. Watch, homie, watch.
I would say Gina because it seems like she buys like a lot of things online.
Yeah.
Just like, you know, like just like
a lot of things.
I mean, what does that have to do with high maintenance?
It seems like you like to keep up with like a lot of like things in your life. Or just, you know, you like buying like a lot of like bougie things.
Buying a lot of bougie things.
All right. Yeah. There's a difference between high maintenance and materialistic. Mm. I like to buy myself shit and just stare at it. Mm. You can tell by my fucking 6-inch roots I'm not high maintenance. Mm-hmm. You can tell that my nails are fucking real acrylics, that I'm not high maintenance.
Acrylics!
Oh,
damn.
Acrylics,
first
purple
time
hair.
Acrylics in 4 years.
Purple hair,
I ain't
blue hair.
Doesn't apply to me, but anyway.
Acrylics. Purple hair, blue hair. You don't even have any roots. I just like to buy things.
My black roots are showing.
Not as bad as mine. Look at this. I let myself go. I'm chubby right now.
I look
now.
More like shit
I look
than you
fucked
do.
Up right now, okay?
Well, that's like, I'm assuming that's more than 2 months. This is only 2 months.
What? I don't even understand.
Yeah, that was the reverse.
I was like, wait, what? So I would say I like to buy things. I'm very materialistic, but I'm not high maintenance. Like, I don't need crazy awesome stuff to survive. I drive one of the cheaper cars here. So, high maintenance. Damn, this is fucking hard.
Cause it's yours.
No, it's not mine.
Girl, it's...
Oh, he volunteers. Let me give it to him and he'll pass it.
All right. Tell us what you know, Casey.
Holy shit.
Tell us what you know.
I know two people here at this very table that work very closely to this one person. One's married to this person, and one's an assistant to this person.
Mm.
And both those two people, I see them stressed out over the tasks that are given to them as wife and assistant. Mm. And that person that gives out those tasks is Bart.
But I'm the judge, so it doesn't even work.
Oh! 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 Oh!
He's
like high maintenance. I'm actually not.
You
it's just,
fucking
no,
are.
No, no, no,
who
look.
Has the AC here. Blowing right now?
Mm. No, but I'm actually not. It's just the tasks that are given out are so simple-minded to me, but so difficult for other people to understand.
Oh, that is jerk.
They're easy.
No, girl, it's
what?
Not.
Who has to go to bed at 10 p.m. every single night?
Yeah, and who has to eat regularly or else
but
they can't even drive. They can't even drive.
Who can live through anything?
But it doesn't matter because he's the judge, no matter what you guys
say. Can we both
you guys should have a mute.
We should overpower the judge.
Overpower
the judge.
There's no way because I'm the judge and that's
we
not going to happen.
So who keeps it, judge?
Eyebrows aren't done.
I'm still listening.
No, we have to move on.
Eyebrows are fucked. Hair is fucked. I haven't done laundry. My nails are real and fucking growing out. It's not me.
It's going to Casey because he fucked up.
Damn.
This ain't, it's not even a real card for me.
I know, it's like,
I'm like,
you don't even
need
a bed to sleep.
Yeah. You
didn't
fall for me, though. I am pretty fucking
heavy. He sleeps on chair.
He does. Dude.
You did, yeah, I'm sorry.
You should like, just take it.
No.
He tried.
I got two.
He
fuck
tried
that.
Backing
no,
you
no,
up,
no,
girl.
No, no, no.
He's pretty far from losing.
We'll buy you food for taking that fall.
Makes best friends with the Uber driver.
Mm.
Who takes the Uber the most here?
Mm.
Nobody
takes the Uber. I don't even have an Uber account. But I think what it's saying is who's the friendliest in here. Like, who's the most
friendliest to strangers?
Friendliest to strangers out of everybody here.
Multiple strangers.
I'm blue, da ba dee da ba da.
Oh wait, is he the judge? Are you judge?
Yeah, Josh is the
Because he was an actual Uber driver.
Oh yeah.
I was a Lyft
driver.
Yeah,
he's the
same thing.
Same thing. Oh my god.
Well, since none of us really use Uber,
maybe it's canceled.
Most friendly.
Well, we're gonna go with the most.
Oh, the most friendliest person here.
Well,
to strangers.
With everyone.
Friendly to strangers?
Yeah.
Multiple social strangers. Butterfly over here, my girlfriend!
Oh!
Hey, girlfriend!
That's true.
I know,
You're so friendly.
I make everyone my friend.
You will talk to them even if you don't want to talk to them anymore.
Yeah. Yeah. That's
into deep.
It's true.
Yeah. Jesus, like, look.
Then you gotta keep it then. You're keeping it?
No.
It's true. No, but it is true.
Because I feel like there's someone even friendlier than me. Someone here at this table that will go above and beyond to make sure that that person
I'm blue,
is comfortable. And not only that, but...
Oh!
What is Julia?
But those are like all great treats.
Those are great treats, though. You're great
losing.
Is that what this expansion pack is like?
I don't know.
Oh my god! I even noticed your hair looks like a blue apple. It's awesome.
I can't be the friendliest because I'm the most awkward person here.
But you make friends. Girl.
But then when I'm awkward, I creep people out. So I don't think
with
I'm the friendliest.
Yes.
With friendliness,
nice.
You creep them out. With friendliness, yeah.
I creep them out. Yeah. No, I creep them out.
Because I can't imagine you like.
Don't talk to me.
Never.
Yeah, hey. Can you imagine me doing that?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, right?
Oh, so hell yeah.
That's my shot. That's
hell
my shot.
Yeah, yeah.
Fine, I'll take it. I'll take one for the team.
That's not even
nice.
That's just you. That's just you. We'll take it for the team. It's you.
Needs to be center of attention.
Ooh.
That's like everybody here.
Yeah. This is all what we do for a living.
I guess you can just pick who you want.
I think Joe is the most eccentric.
Yeah,
I agree.
I like how you're trying to diffuse it. You're like, it's everyone here.
No, it's Joe.
It's the one in full costume right now.
No.
Hey, but I don't need to be. I'm just the default. It just happens.
You're so good at it. It's already
natural. No, it's just it's like that's the life. It happens. Who here is always camera ready though? Once you pull out that camera and they turn around, they're like, yes, it's this glamorous, glamorous person.
You know what's funny?
Center of attention?
In Hawaii, David started catching on. Anytime he would point his camera at you, he would start posing.
I noticed that. He's like, did it on purpose.
No, he said you didn't. He's like, watch, look at Tiff. And he would go like this, just looking at him, she's just like.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
There you go, give me views.
See, I don't crave that. That's a clear.
Yeah. Okay, hold on. You're saying that I crave attention? Because if you all remember when I first started coming around, how hard was it for me to even talk to a camera?
That's the past,
girl.
That was
the past.
No, exactly.
You can't be talking about a statue of limitations.
That's part of me. That's my personality.
It is the statue of limitations.
That's part of me.
But we grow and we bloom.
I'm not trying to be a center of attention.
But you did change a lot in many different ways.
But no, I'm going back to Joe because you are clear. Dude, look at all these holes. Look at all your rage for JK Party. You love being center of attention.
That's not center of attention. That's anger problems.
No,
that I need to
go through. Who's always playing musical instruments.
That's embarrassing.
During JK News, who's the one that keeps interrupting? It's you, Joe.
That's
you can't.
True.
You can't fight.
I'm not interrupting, trying to be the center of attention. It's because I'm curious and I have ADD.
Even right now, I was trying to say yes, you are. You're like, bleh. You have to talk over people. It's you.
That's because I'm curious. That
you.
Doesn't mean attention.
It's you.
I think this person is the center of attention because in the center of the club, she's dancing.
Oh,
what happened to the past statute of limitations? I'm not even there anymore. You can't bring that up again.
Yeah,
so you've been late to work.
What are you doing?
I'm not trying to be the center of attention anymore.
You're exactly being the center of attention.
Judge, what do you say?
Gina, rule the river, Joe. That's why I'm the star of the show, bitch.
This one says, never gets embarrassed, and I vote Bart.
For sure!
Yeah,
for
sure!
That's
you don't even need an explanation.
You need to give an explanation.
The explanation is,
yeah.
Let's go back to the credit carding in Hawaii.
Okay. But there's a wedding party coming in too.
In Hawaii, the wedding party, we all know I got there first.
But it's a public shower.
Exactly.
That's public. Disgusting.
So public. It's a public shower.
You're not supposed to get naked.
I already peed there. I already marked my territory.
Wow! Okay, you're already
that's your card.
No. I marked my territory. So that's mine. So if they come and they know that there's pee there,
public means they for the
see
public.
Me credit carding my ass, they know that that is my shower.
That's disgusting.
So if they want to come and rinse their little feet off, hey.
Who would be too embarrassed to do that in public? Liar! You did it!
Alright, it's Bart.
What?
That was bad.
What?
You guys are disgusting.
Makes terrible first impression.
Oh,
no.
Oh.
No.
I just had that talk in my head.
I'm sorry.
A terrible first impression. God, this is very relative. Like,
I can help you if you need it.
Me too.
Well, why?
What are you leaning back for?
But why?
That's the thing, I don't know, but why? I can't.
Because I put a good impression on you.
Yeah, high five. Yeah. See, like, I don't know. Everyone's left a good impression on me the first time I met them. Yeah.
Well, think of parents or other professionals or people that aren't weird like us.
That's true. Professionally, if I were to sit down and have a meeting with you, I would be kind of, might be weird. Like, I would think you're kind of fucking crazy, and I don't know if I want to do business with you. That's gonna go in between you two. You guys decide.
Both of you two.
I don't know.
We know how to put on correct hats. When we go meet people in Hollywood and white people in business suits.
Wait a minute.
Wait, no, I think so. Bad first impression, Josh. Holy shit.
Oh my god.
Are you serious? First time I met you, we were playing JK party games. I'm just like, yo, hurry the fuck up, dude. Like, it's so stressful.
Damn, you traumatize her like that?
Yeah.
On the first impression? That's terrible. That's 3 out of the 4 words
you
on that card.
You stressed me out like the first time we played together.
God, I can't.
That's the closest I can get to a first impression.
Because he moves at a speed of sloth.
It was you and Zootopia.
I am shocked.
Yeah.
I am shocked. First time I met you, I said, hi, my name is Josh.
You didn't. And
No, you didn't. I introduced myself.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
Yes.
Well, I don't know. You're on the chopping block. She already called you out. What do you got to say to that?
No, because then whenever I meet someone, I usually like introduce myself. I say, hey, my name is Josh. Or it's like, I'm just saying. But I'm trying to think who else this card could go to. Because I remember the first time I met all of you guys, actually.
You were really nice.
Yeah, I remember the first time we actually met was in the Ode song, and you guys are all pretty nice.
Yeah.
First time I met Tiff, she was pretty nice. Julia was pretty nice.
That's what you said.
You gotta keep it, Josh.
Yeah. So, yep, I looked.
Wow! Hold on, I'm the judge.
Oh,
change of plans.
Because I kind of want to nominate someone.
Uh-oh.
Because out of everyone in this table, there was one person that I kind of had a bad first impression. And that was Gio.
Ooh.
Mexican on Mexican crime!
If David was here, you would agree. Because David told me the story that he thought that you were Italian, man. Because you speak so mean to him over text.
And I said
he was a bitch before we got together. It's expressionless, that's what it was.
He didn't say mean, he said because it was Gio and it was very direct. Women don't speak very directly, especially when it comes to business conversation, so that's what he meant.
Therefore, comma, bad first impression.
Sorry, girl, but
wow.
It took some time.
Mm. Gets convinced strangers are celebrities.
Oh, I know who that one is.
So I swear to you, I think like every day this person sees like 7 celebrities. Every day.
What?
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
I can back her up. Well, he does actually see celebrities, but there's times when he thinks he sees a celebrity, but it's not them.
Aww.
I purposely do it as a joke, because it'll just be like a random tall guy with dark hair on the, oh look, it's Tom Hanks. And it's just because I have a fun imagination.
So that card's yours.
Cool. Yeah.
I'm not convinced, I know that guy's fake.
Oh, I mean, I guess you're the closest to that in this room.
just changed. Give me 5 seconds. Who?
I don't think anyone else said that.
I couldn't back you up on that because I knew that she had me.
Even when we're driving.
Oh shit!
Fine, it's mine. You guys are freaking scandalous.
This person knows fucking everything. I'm gonna give this to Josh.
Wait, what?
Yellowfish.
Because when we play games, dude, you say it with conviction and you trip us up, and we're just like, but it's happened so many times to the point where we're like, dude, you don't know it.
There's and times yellow mafia, there's no evidence, and for some reason, like, you say things it. As if you're a psychic, and then you're wrong.
Okay,
is somehow still alive. I would have to say this goes to Tiff, because she only eats salt. Tahini and maybe an occasional gobstopper, and that's it. I don't know how
she's still alive. True, I barely even drink water, you're right. But I am gonna take this more in terms of like how you were born with allergies and shit, and I'm just surprised you're even existing in this world, Casey. You're what? Allergic to everything. Aww. Like everything.
Allergy meds.
That's how you've been staying alive.
You just look like you live a really crazy life, so.
No, but No.
You live a life on the wild side,
huh? Crazy life as portrayed on the internet.
Mi vida loca.
But, like I said,
you have the same shady friends.
And we all know that, no. Well, they used to roll them.
Life, nightlife.
That's a ton of limitations. That gets crazy. Never wants to do anything. Remember that? I don't do anything. The person that should somehow not be alive.
Is high maintenance? Come on.
Is Bart.
What?
Because, dude, you do like the craziest things.
Like
unless
what?
you were in the military. So that gives it another notch.
What's name one thing that's crazy?
You like to shoot guns, like awesome like guns, huge guns, yeah.
But he gets the crazy ideas where it's like shit that like can like ricochet off and like kill himself.
Yeah. he's like, oh, I want to jump off a fucking mountain and see if I can fly onto an airplane.
Well, no, he's
like,
afraid of heights.
I'm afraid of heights.
Well, that you have crazy ideas.
Remember like, this story that because I didn't know where he was because he was swimming
on the racetrack too. On the racetrack, he almost crashed the car.
What racetrack?
There's a lot of reasons why you shouldn't
be alive.
Everyone's always worried
about
you.
He has a lot of allergies.
What racetrack?
When you guys did a drifting.
You're blind as a bat.
Oh, the drifting.
The drifting.
Oh, he almost blew up the car.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
I was a little worried when Bart was just pegged on the floor with the throttle, and I just heard.
I am a survivor, but this car does not belong to me because.
I think it does.
Bye!
End up with?
So,
he lives life too dangerously.
Nope. I am convinced that strangers are celebrities. So I got bubbles in my brain. I'm happy. Is a troll. Once again, I like to have fun and fucks with people. Will coach a kid's soccer team be way too into that? I'm passionate. Somehow still alive. I got classy ideas. Never gets embarrassed. This is a fucking happy face, dude.
It took a while.
I'll do it for the camera. This is a motherfucking happy face life.
That's pretty good. Well, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Drunk Stoner Stupid. Now you know who the crazy lifer is. Make sure to stay close. Check out all our other channels. Cruise to the description down below. Until next time. Bye-bye!
Bye.
Ew, I just touched your booger wand.
Who's this one is a fucking genius?
Give that to me!